The most common way to create beam effects is using the new shape editor. This allows you to create a shape for beam effects, change its parameters, and add effects to create cues for beam shows in live operation. Start by right-clicking on any empty cell of your workspace, click Create and New Shape. On the top left, we have our standard New, Open, and Save. This will save this entire window into a separate file to share or move around. You can also publish to the cloud, change the cue properties, and how it's previewed using these buttons. Next, we have the abilities to save your shape to the Quick Shapes tab. Freeze the cue to lower processing time if your cue doesn't move, which is super useful for very complex shows. Turn the shape into an object in the object tree, which is covered separately, or copy this shape as a frame into the clipboard. Below that, you have your preview window for your shape. Note, this can be seen in 3D by clicking and dragging and right-clicking to reset. On the top right, we can assign a zone to this shape, then enable output by clicking Show It Now, so we can see it in real life. Next, we have all the parameters for the basic shape, which shape it is, circle, lines, triangle, square, and many more. All the way to the right, you have the option for solid lines or point shapes. You can also make your points be connected by toggling the Connected Beams button. Lastly, on the right, you have the Static Corners option. On shapes with corners, you can force a point in the corner to always maintain the shape. Below that, we have our size parameter to change the shape's size. Next, we select how many points it has. I look for 1 to 24 for beam shapes and 100 to 300 for line shapes. Beam speed for beam shapes. And points per beam, which is how many hardware points on your laser for each visible point in your shape. 10 is a great default for scan rate and brightness. You can increase this value for more brightness if you have less beam points, or decrease it if you have lots of beam points. And finally, it's color, where you can select from these predefined, or double-click the white box on the right to choose your own color entirely. Now that we have created our basic shape, we can now add effects here. Please watch our effect tutorial series for a full description of effects, but for now we can add some basic oscillation effects like zoom, position X, and vertical waves. All these effects I will want to make beat-based so that the speed follows system BPM at the top of Beyond. From there, we can press OK and it will store in the queue cell we started with and put it into your workspace. Be sure to save your workspace to save your queue in the grid. Thank you for watching our quick hints video on the new shape editor. If you still have questions, feel free to email support@pangolin.com. It'll help you as soon as possible. As well, be sure to check out our tutorials on effects to help you create better laser effects. Thanks for watching.